Assalamualaikum. Today I am taking class 2, subject EVS, topic, a body needs food.
Dear children, like car needs petrol to run. Isn't it? Like that, a body also needs energy to work. This comes from food. And from where do we get food? We get food from plants and from animals.
What are the foods we get from plants? We get roots, vegetables, grains in the sense wheat, ragi, rice. Okay. And we get food from animals like egg, honey, chicken, milk. Now, you have wondered why food is required. Why it is required our body? Food is required because it gives energy to work and play. It gives us strong bones, strong teeth and strong muscles. It protects us from disease, that is help us to grow. See, we get food from various plants and animals. Now, let us learn three groups of food. Energy giving food, body building food, protective food. Now let us learn in detail. What are energy giving foods?
So food can be divided into three groups. Let us learn first one. Energy giving food. Foods such as bread, potato, cheese, carrot, oil, pulses, cereals, these are called energy giving food. Rice, sugar gives us energy to work and play. The food which gives us energy to work and play, they are called energy giving food. Now, next is body building food. Foods such as milk, nuts, pulses, eggs, fish and meat make our body strong and help us to grow. Bodybuilding food means it makes our bones and muscles strong. This is known as bodybuilding food. Next is protective food. What are protective food? Protective food which protect us from diseases like vegetables and fruits. Vegetables and fruits keep our bodies healthy and protect us from disease. So these three types of food which gives us energy. Protective food, bodybuilding food, energy giving food. So, the food we eat every day is called our diet. See, all of us do not have the same diet. We eat different kinds of food. Do you know, children, some people eat only fruits, vegetables, grains and milk products. They are called vegetarians. They are not at all eating egg, meat and fish. So, there are some people who also eat meat, fish and eggs along with these vegetables. For them we call non-vegetarians.
Now, here one more type of food is there which you like most. There are some food that are very tasty but are not good for health. Why? Because they have too much oil, fat and sugar that harm our body. They are called junk food. Eating junk food regularly is not good. We may eat them only once in a while, not every day. So you should not force your parents to take you out to eat pizza, burger, french fries, jalebis and
especially the chips. What you are getting, the chips, noodles, Lays and this all, you should not at all eat. Every day if you eat, then you fall sick. Okay, children, so avoid eating junk food. Eat healthy food which gives you energy to work and play.
Now, let us learn about some good eating habits. Eat fresh and home-cooked food. I told before only you should not eat junk food which prepared outside. So you should eat only home-cooked food. We should not eat junk food which is prepared outside. Eat fresh and home-cooked food. Eat food items from all the three groups which I have shown. Energy giving food, body building food, protective food. Eat from this group. Have meals on time every day. Wash fruits and vegetables before eating or cooking. Take only as much food on your plate as you can eat. Do not waste your food. Do not overeat or waste food. Along with this, you have to drink plenty of water. Every day you have to drink 6 to 8 glass of water. So dear children, I hope from today you will not trouble your mother to have food. Now you have learned which are the good foods, which are the foods good for your health. So don't trouble your parents for food. Now you have to. So dear children, don't trouble your parents for junk food and eat healthy food which your mother makes at home. Now you have to complete Now you have to complete main A, main B and main C. Main A and B on your page number 24 and main C question and answers in your classwork. Thank you.